A ceremony was held today with all three branches of the South Korean military to mark the country's 73rd Armed Forces Day. In a speech at the event, President Moon said his recent proposal of declaring a formal end to the Korean War was based on the military's readiness to defend the country. In any case, however, he stressed that South Korea will respond sternly to threats. Kim Min-ji reports.
President Moon Jae-in says he called for a declaration to end the 1950-53 Korean War based on his pride in South Korea's defense readiness. He spoke on Friday at a ceremony to mark the country's Armed Forces Day. Moon made the proposal last week during his UN General Assembly address to declare an end to the war that ended with an armistice with related parties.
나는 우리 군을 신뢰합니다. 나는 우리의 든든한 안보 태세에 자부심을 갖고 있습니다. 이러한 신뢰와 자부심을 바탕으로 나는 한반도 종전선언과 화해와 협력의 새로운 시대를 국제사회에 제안했습니다.
Moon's message comes amid a sticky situation on the peninsula, following a series of missile launches by North Korea, while it continues to issue statements regarding the development of inter-Korean relations. Moon said as a commander-in-chief, his top responsibility is to establish peace on the Korean peninsula. He added that the government will respond sternly to any threats. However, he did not mention North Korea's missiles directly.
국군 최고 통수권자의 첫 번째이자 가장 큰 책무는 한반도의 항구적 평화를 만들고 지키는 것입니다. 이는 곧 우리 군의 사명이기도 합니다. 국민의 생명과 안전을 위협하는 그 어떤 행위에 대해서도 정부와 군은 단호히 대응할 것입니다.
Moon said that South Korea will further boost its defense posture and will develop more powerful missiles after Seoul and Washington agreed to scrap missile guidelines. He also highlighted the recent military feats, such as the testing of a submarine-launched ballistic missile and development of a prototype of the KF-21 fighter jet. Moon noted the increase to next year's defense budget proposed of roughly $47.6 billion. That's up 37% since 2017, the start of Moon's term. This year's ceremony was held with the country's navy for the first time in the southern port city of Pohang, where forces launched their first military landing operation during the 1950-53 Korean War. The Army, Navy and Air Force performed a joint landing operation incorporating advanced technology to highlight the country's military strength. Kim Min-ji, Arirang News.